Pretend that instead of spending 10 minutes writing a charter for a project you just made up, think about using this for a real engagement with a client, or perhaps to help a client get their project off on a good start. What do you think would be the most difficult part of doing this with a client?
Convincing them the value.
Okay, convincing the client of the value could be difficult. Okay. How would you overcome that obstacle? How could you convince the client that maybe this is worth their time?
Definition of the deliverables.
Okay, so how would that convince the client? Definition of deliverables.
So that they know what they're going to get when it's done.
Okay, hey, Mr. Client, you want to be sure you're going to get what you really want? Let's write it down now. Okay, that would be a good approach. What did you see as perhaps the biggest advantages and disadvantages of doing this chartering process on a project?
Well, the advantage is that you're setting a foundation of what to work on.
Okay. So setting an advantage is setting a foundation to build your project on or to build your work on. Okay. That is really important, because if you don't, you may go off in the wrong direction. Mm-hmm. You and then you.
We generally find that our clients develop their own sense of clarity mm-hmm. of what it is that they're trying to accomplish okay. by the time we're done with the charter. You know,
okay.
they know.
Okay. Absolutely. Doing a charter is a team effort with you and your client. Helps both of you develop a real sense of clarity on what's going to happen. You had a point.
Yeah, I think the other thing that I find is that it helps predetermine scope, so that scope creep is essentially reduced at any rate. And the second point is the client investment gets higher.
Okay. So this is an excellent weapon for battling scope creep. Scope creep kills a lot of projects. And if you want to manage creeping scope, you first have to have a baseline or a foundation to start with. That's your charter. And your second point was this helps the value of the engagement grow?
Well, the champion becomes invested because it's their stuff. And so you get a leg up on getting that support that you need before you ever start.
Buy-in is really important.
Yeah.
And the best way I know of to get buy-in is to let people get their fingerprints on things. The charter is an excellent way to invite key people on the client side to get their fingerprints on the project. They're part of defining what it's going to be. They're going to be more invested in making sure it happens and it's successful. Yes?
And also, it brings the people together. I mean, the three of us started talking about something we knew absolutely nothing mm-hmm. about, so we had our own paradigms and visions and frames of reference, and it forces us to get in alignment so
Very
that
good.
The three of us actually work in the same thing versus, well, okay, now that meeting's done, I'm going to go back and tell my group what I think we really ought to be doing.
So it brings people with very different perspectives together, kind of a meeting of the minds, some understanding.
You got to have alignment.
Yeah. Now, the funny thing about this, I was telling this team over here, if I could only pick one project management tool on a project, it would probably be this one. It seems, wow, such a simple tool. Why? But this is a really powerful tool, and I would actually be willing to throw away the piece of paper that you wrote. That's a valuable piece of paper, the agreement you reach, the document forms valuable. But what's even more valuable is just that team experience you were talking about. That's what's real value here. So as far as why they work, I think we've basically covered a lot of it here. It's your initial agreement to help arrest that scope creep monster. You can use this as an internal marketing plan, by the way. This can become your elevator pitch, especially inside the client. If the client needs to start selling this project within, this is a good place to start that process.